1, 2, 3,
boom! The Dayton annual Rocky Horror Picture Show has been going on for 10 decadent years. From stage building to props, production, choreography, and everything in between. These students do everything in their power to make this show a success, even having the opportunity to win the Golden Dildo Award. So why does Dayton put this show on every year? How has this show changed these past 10 years? Why do people love Rocky?
I love the community. It's just such a good group of people. It's so accepting. Everyone is high energy most of the time. And I also love performing because it's such an interactive show. Like, it's not you on a stage reciting a line. It's you having an experience with the audience. And that's what I loved about Rocky.
Because it allows people to, you know, put themselves into the shoes of the people who they're either portraying as, whether that be the main cast, or puts themselves into their different kind of, like, I call it like a different skin that you put yourself into for the show.
It's very different in the fact that, at least the way we do it and a lot of other groups do it, is that it's not really, it's not a play. It's really interactive. It's sort of like a movie with physical commentary.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of verbal commentary too, but I think that it's theater for those who aren't necessarily here.
Gender's like turned on its head. It's not really even mentioned, which is really great to me because we try to genderize so many things in our society where it's completely unnecessary. And while sometimes gendering things, you know, is important, there's also a limit, and I think we've far surpassed that limit.
Since we've been here for so long, we have kind of a cult following, so, you know, a vast majority of UD doesn't even know we exist, but then there's the few that are, you know, holding out every year waiting to go. Like, yeah, I had a couple people come up to me after the show. One, she'd never seen it before, but she said her group of friends were going to show up every year, learn every callback afterwards. It was just so great.
Callbacks are the heart and soul of Rocky Horror. You can't show up to Rocky Horror and not be a part of the show. Just by being there, you're included. You are, there's no fourth wall, there's no, it's kind of like a rock concert. It's like rock concert theater. And it's weird, because like, there's a movie playing, so it's cinema, and then there's live actors, so it's theater, and then, at least in the version we do, you have this standing audience around that's shouting stuff back. It's almost like singing lyrics at a concert, and it's like the best of all worlds.
Is all of them an answer?
What's that smell?
Cover it up!
One that I really like is the, when Jana asked me what kind of a place is this, and I responded, it's probably just some kind of hunting lodge for rich weirdos. And the callback is described locally, so I like that one a lot. That's a local one that I appreciate.
Hey Riff, show us how you finger fuck your sister. This way.
This year in particular, one of my personal favorites has been when Riff Raff says, I think perhaps you better both come inside. But the audience says, I think perhaps you better both fuck off, come inside. I can't come that far.
It's a critical statement to prove it.
Can we have a picnic? No. Picnic.
When they're in the lab and Dr. Scott is just introduced, and he goes, hey, Scotty, and everybody just goes, suck my cocky.
Hey, Scotty, suck my cocky, because I would use that to get everyone's attention, which was awesome.
Dr. Scott, suck my cock.
Anal sex, oral sex, and whips, and chains.
Oh, shit, I missed the bus.
Fuck the back row!
Fuck the front row!
Are you in the middle?
Well, it was a lot more work than I thought it was going to be. Getting the area to teach people and then actually teaching was a lot more difficult than I thought it was going to be. So, but I still enjoyed it in the end, because then I got to see everybody do awesome on stage, and I was like, yeah. I was that dance mom cheering on her babies, like, go, you got this.
But just from sitting out on production meetings, they talked a lot about the stage. The stage and finances were the two biggest things because we made that huge investment.
I love acting, I love all that, but it was good to have something physical. Like, I could point at the show and say, I did that. That right there.
Like, I think I spent 3-4 nights in a row just going to Tim's, staying there until 5-6 a.m., and then going home after building all night. Building shit, drilling shit, figuring out what we need to do, solving problems, listening to Darren yell, like, doing things that you wouldn't normally associate with being in a show, right? With being in a musical production or something like that.
Why Tim's? Well, Tim's has a stripper pole. It's dirty, it's dingy, and so is Rocky. So it's a match made in heaven. When I first approached Tim's about it, they had no idea what they were getting into. And Marty, the owner, who's a personal friend of mine now, I remember during Tech Week, he said to turn to one of his bartenders and said, what the fuck did we just get ourselves into?
Back through old cast pictures from the first couple years that they did it here, there was maybe 6 people in chorus for like the total. And then my freshman year, there was probably about 20, probably like 20 total of like cast members, 20 or 25. And I remember telling my sister about that and she was just shocked. She was like, wow, that's so big. Or, you know, we've never had like a troupe that size. And I was like, I didn't really think it was that big. Or we had 40 people in it. It doubled because we never did cuts before. That was something that we never did for audition. It was an experience, not one that we want to repeat, because Tim's is definitely not big enough for 40 people. And you also don't get to bond as well with everyone.
In the course of our 10-year history, we've actually donated over $10,000 to philanthropies.
I'm just glad that it was for charity and not a for-profit thing.
Right.
I've never done theater for money before, so that's not a good idea.
I wanted to honestly put something more local. So Equitas is all over Ohio, and yeah, they have a branch in Dayton, but we thought maybe switching to the LGBT Center of Greater Dayton would be better because it's more local. They do stuff through, Equitas does stuff through them as well, so there's still that support there too.
Well, previous to Dayton's production, I've seen the movie Rocky. I'd never seen it live. So I watched it in high school because I was in the theater, and obviously in the theater, you always watch Rocky. It's just a tradition. And I thought it was really boring. But so, because my best friend Leah was in it, I had known about the tradition of Mark with a V. And so when I was told, go on stage and fake an orgasm, I was like, well, fuck yeah, let's go. Like, let's do it. I totally understand why people love it because it's so much fun to be surrounded by people who are having a good time and singing along and drinking and quoting things as they come up. And even though I had no idea about what was going on, it was just fun to be there, like, up front, seeing it firsthand. It was great. I loved it.
I remember trying to recruit one year, and I went to the cheerleading table, because it was at yours, and I was like, you guys are cheerleaders. Like, you have rhythm, you can do things. Would you be interested in, like, trying out for Rocky? And one cheerleader turned to me, and he was like, you would never do that in a million years. Like, straight out, was just not for it. Everyone else didn't even respond, because he was like, no way.
Which is crazy, because we had Troy this year.
Exactly.
Who is a male cheerleader.
Yeah.
We had a lot more guys in chorus this year, which is really nice, because he had, like, little Rocky, like, Buckyettes or something. I don't know. I don't know what they decided to call him, but I thought that was interesting. So we had a little bit more of diverse cast.
We're both in a bit of a hurry.
I'd see it, instead of just Friday and Saturday, I'd hopefully see it selling out every night, maybe making it popular enough that we can do it a couple weekends out of the year in just one.
Bigger, better. So many more alumni. In 10 years from now, who knows, it might not even be at 10 anymore. They might do it at some other bar, or it might be outside, or we'll have like 10 shows a year.
If you haven't seen the show, you should definitely give it a try. It's not for everyone. Some people are a little turned off by it, but for a lot of people, it's really great. They love it to come back every year, every night. It's just kind of a time to let loose and just not really worry about anything except having fun, which is something that is definitely good for a lot of people. So I recommend giving it a try, and if you're at all interested in being in it, also try and be in it.
Just give it a chance. It's probably the place where you'll find yourself the most because everyone's accepting of who you are, however you are, and however you come.